Did you wake up today and Claude Code stopped working with OpenCode? And you're wondering what's actually going on? Well, in this video, we're just going to go over what the drama is, what's going on, and how you should think about using OpenCode and your certain model providers moving forward. All right, to go into what is the drama, well, we can see in the OpenCode issues, this issue was opened up 15 hours ago, and you probably woke up this morning like me, and you saw this lovely message saying, hey, credentials is only authorized for the use with Claude Code and cannot be used with any other API request. let me tell you, this broke a lot of open source projects because they were actually using this OAuth token to make API requests with Claude. Because, well, if you buy a Claude Code subscription, it's actually cheaper than just using the API. And I've done that for pretty several months now, and I've really loved Claude Code. And I enjoy using it with OpenCode. So I'm very sad to see this happen. And you can see there's a lot of responses to this thread. Everyone is just going on about it, very upset. Some people even canceling their subscriptions because of this. We can go on. We can see there's like 242 just comments going on about what's going on here. There's people trying to make fixes to get around it. So they still have the OAuth and then they're trying to mimic the tools. So their tool names are the same to match Claude Code. So they're kind of spoofing around, but I don't think that's really going to last. So it's not really a full-blown solution to kind of bet on. But this kind of takes a very interesting take now, because you have to wonder from an AI provider's perspective, like Claude Code, if they're doing this, what is the fallout? Well, from Twitter, you know, I think, let's just go to Twitter quote. We can see some people are already not really pleased by this. So I've just got the Primogen here, you know, just mocking like he's feeling the AGI this morning because he can't actually access it through OpenCode. And that's how it pretty much looks in OpenCode. He's using his build agent there. Looking at some other accounts, you know, so another big one, DAH, this is like the Creative Reborn Rails. So quite a big account with over, you know, 591 followers. And we can also see his opinion on this whole debacle is also like he also loves the Anthropic models, but new hopes that this is a mistake, that they're actually blocking alternative, you know, providers like OpenCode and other external open source repos from this because it is quite hostile. And it also makes you wonder, can you even rely on it anymore? Well, probably not. I think Claude Code wants to keep everyone in their ecosystem because their model's the best at coding and they want to keep it that way. If I literally just scroll through my Twitter feed, I can just see there's just a lot of people upset about this. You know, some are trying to make workarounds and others are just like wondering what is going to happen next. And what's funny enough, this just also happened to land on the same day OpenCode was launching their Black product, which is here, which is like $200 a month. And you can use their selective models in OpenCode, or so say OpenCode provider, and they will have access to Claude models, GPT models, Gemini models, all of that. And it does seem they're using a different provider and they're not actually just using Claude Code. They're going through the Gemini side of things, but it's kind of interesting how much this like flooded out. All right. And because of all this like Claude Code drama, OpenCode actually released a new product called Black, which was just, you could get access to all the OpenCode models for $200 a month for a certain usage fee. And that got sold within under a minute. It literally just went on Twitter and it was sold. The guys at OpenCode were actually in a meeting. They didn't even see it pop up on their phone yet, and it was sold. That was just like how quick the demand is going and how much anger there is at Anthropic now. I think people are just looking for an alternative that doesn't lock them in. And I wonder how many other providers will actually kind of have this model where you can just have different models all in one and then use it under the hood. We already know Anti-Gravity does this a little bit with the AI Pro. You can use some of the Opus models, but I kind of want to know if this is a new aspect coming in, especially for the coding side of things. All right, I kind of want to just bring this last one here. It's by Dax. You know, he was just talking about the Anthropic stuff, like all the issues that are happening. And, you know, he is 100% right. It's their business. They can actually enforce their terms however they like. So if they don't want people using their software through another API, they're more than entitled to do that. It does have ripple effects, how people want to look and use them. And what does that actually mean for you? So I just want to get real with you. I think having all your bets on one model is probably not the best way. I'm a very stern believer on trying to understand the process or steps made while developing, and how do you keep that consistent? And then if you need a model, how well is that model providing value in terms of those steps? Is it actually improving or decreasing? Or is it actually a pro or con? Or better yet, can you just use any model with that workflow? And this is kind of where I hope you guys are starting to think a little bit with your AI coding. You're not just like looking at the model and hoping the model does everything. Because if you want to look at history or even systems and processes in general, everything follows a pattern. And I think you need to think about the patterns that you're building in. And you have to kind of think, okay, how do you build things in a certain way that makes it more consistent? All right, I don't have all the answers, but this is how I'm starting to think about this. And I'm going to keep with OpenCode. I'm not too worried about if Anthropic opens it up or not. I will cancel my subscription and I'll move to a different model, because I actually really like the OpenCode like experience, how it works. And if I can get a different experience with the same type of model, it doesn't really matter, because I'm really trying to define the processes that I use while developing. And a bit of those processes is how context is injected. And this has been a lot of my focus in the last couple of months. It's really trying to understand, if I give the model what type of context, how well does it perform? And also, how do I actually constrain it to do different actions? Like, can I rely on the model or the action to do a certain step-by-step process to get me to that result? And I'm going to do this in another video. I don't think this is the video for it. But what I want to show you is like how you can maybe break up your context. You know, for example, I've got this context here, like core systems, core values, essential patterns, navigation. Give the model everything it needs to know how to use different contexts for different scenarios. But if we go into something here, so if we go for API design, we can see this is not a big folder. It's under 400 lines. It's probably a little, could be a little bit less, but it has everything just generally in there. If we jump to another one, it's also very like minimal. We don't want to oversaturate the model with a lot of information. We want to give it kind of like nudge it, like golden nuggets that it can follow without overwhelming the context window. My main like concern here is just keeping the context window low. So I'll save this for another video, going through my open agents repo and really going into all the techniques that are going under the hood with this, and how I'm actually even getting good results with using like Grok code, for example, and actually keeping that consistent, and how you guys should also think about building your systems this way. You know, regardless of the model you use, try and make it more model agnostic as much as possible, because models are getting smarter at the end of the day. And how much more smarter do you really need to get a good AI tooling system if you actually got good processes in place? You know, we know this from the past. If you started coding 8 years ago, you will probably learn a tutorial, understand the coding patterns, and then apply that yourself. And we're kind of doing the same thing with LLMs here. We're making sure it follows the right patterns or procedures that we care about, and then we review it and then make sure it runs. As long as you, as the main person behind, know what you're coding, you've got a lot of room to build on. If you vibe coding, well, maybe this approach is not for you. Anyway, guys, this is just a quick video. All right, so this was just meant to be a quick video just talking about the Claude Code open drama. It wasn't really well scripted, but I kind of want to just give my thoughts on this, and hope you guys are really thinking about how you're building systems to really keep you secure, even if a model is no longer available. Maybe say the internet dies and you can only use open source models on your machine. Can you actually work or not? If the answer is later, you probably have a problem. And you always want to build for contingencies and fail safes. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video. And last shout out, I am working on a few longer videos, so you should see that coming in the next few days or so. And lastly, I'm actually trying to decide what I want to do for a community-wise side of things. I actually really want to interact with you guys personally. I don't know what that form looks like, even if that's a cohort or a community. I'm still trying to decide what actually works for everyone. My aim here is to actually make sure I actually apply value and actually... And lastly, guys, there will be a link down below just to sign up for if you get an email list. I'm thinking of making a community or cohort. I can't really decide what that is yet. I'm more interested in actually connecting with the people, understanding how people think, and actually helping them bring to the next tier. That's actually my main focus, is like, how do I actually give you guys the most value? Maybe it might be a combination between two, but for me, it's really important to interact with people. It keeps me going. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. This will be a quick one out. I hope you guys have a lovely weekend. And you know, if you do use Claude Code like me and are sad about it, well, the good news is you're not alone. And don't worry, we'll get through this mess together and we'll make a better way forward. Anyway, have a great weekend, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Cheers.